Oh, yes. I forgot this is where we were. What was happening again? Something's happening.
James, over
Oh,
here.
I've
Listen.
done this.
Your resident super genius built some kind of experimental machine that's drawing the acrid here and agitating them more than usual.
Why would Kovac build something to cause this?
You're asking the wrong scientist. See the quarantine room in the center of the lab? Right through the glass there? You blast your way in and put a stop to this mess. We'll
Okie
keep them
dokie.
off your tail.
I forget how to take duck behind cover.
Good heavens! How long have you been not dead? Oh, you're just in time to witness my breakthrough. Isn't this spectacular? Look at them all.
Yes, look at them. Can I get out of here? Okay. There we go.
Guys.
Boy, it's been a while since I played this. Come on, that is so totally covered. Not what I wanted to do. Okay, can't remember the controls of the game. Let's see if I can figure it out. Well, that should be all of them dead at least. Let me look at this. Okay, so space is to get behind cover. I don't know.
Unnecessary. I'm sure I only needed to adjust the frequency.
Yeah, sorry for the inconvenience. Hope saving your life didn't put you out.
Oh, no, I forgive you. I know carnage and mayhem is part of your nature, and without it, you just wouldn't be you. Or nearly as useful to me.
You made a device that can drive the acrid crazy.
Well, I would need to run more experiments to know for sure. Establishing a baseline of sanity for these creatures might be prohibitive of itself. Nevertheless, I'm glad the base was able to witness my breakthrough.
Yes, your breakthrough.
Are you telling me you did this on purpose?
No, not at all. But the experiment is still a resounding success. The acrid were influenced. Don't you see? I figured out how they communicate, and I've replicated it. In the course of dissecting many varieties of acrid, I found a receptor that they all had in common. You might understand it as sort of a biological radio receiver, but you'd be stupid because it's vastly more complicated than that.
Oh, well, thank you.
Heat energy is an unusual element with uniquely resonant electromagnetic properties. It's more than blood and energy. It's how the acrid coordinate with each other. It seems I found a vibration frequency that puts them in an agitated state, which is of limited use itself, but just imagine what else we might be able to do with this. If I can find the wavelength that would calm the acrid and render them docile, then harvesting T-energy in the quantities we require would be a matter of simple logistics, such as designing a sufficiently massive slaughterhouse.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and leave you in there.
It's okay. I actually think better in confined spaces.
Yeah, I think that's best too. Hello everyone, and welcome back to Lost Planet 3. Last time, we shut down that crazy machine, and I didn't realize it saved only right before we had done that, so... Oh look, Mr. Crazy is still over here. Hello, Mr. Crazy. Oh! There he goes again. Ookie dookie. Anyways, let me fill up on ammo again, because I had to use some ammo to get through that. And I forgot how to play the game. It's been a while. So, yeah. Like, I forgot how to get behind cover, and I just wasn't used to shooting. It was all great.
James, a moment?
Yes?
Listen, I don't want to cause a general panic or anything, but just glancing at Coronis while heading in, she's in bad shape. The way the storms are increasing in intensity, I'm concerned it's only a matter of time until the structural integrity is compromised.
I don't know, Doc. Seems like a pretty good reason to panic. You got any suggestions?
I may. There are some tests I'd like to run, but I'd need your help. Wait for my call and we'll chat properly. In the meantime, I'm sure Braddock wants to catch up with you.
And I do believe that is where we ended last time, so...
Acrid are retreating. Looks like Delta Station's in the clear.
The swarm is subsiding in the hangar as well. Whatever you did seemed to work, Jim. We're ever thankful.
I'm happy to help. Just glad to be back home.
Now we use elevator, which I seem to be completely missing. How come I can keep picking up ammo? It's like each giving me one shotgun shell or something like that. It's crazy. All right.
Science is not an exact science. At its best, science is chaotic and unpredictable. Often produces a foul odor that you cannot scrub from your fingers. Nature has bottomless mysteries and contradictions, a fanfare of ironies and impossibilities. Male seahorses bearing litters. Frogs consuming their own offspring. Entire population infused with its planet's lifeblood. I've observed these things with my own eyes. I've carved the verities of truth from them with my bare hands.
With my bare hands.
I do mean any answer can be dissected into being. Any secret can be cut open. And the scalpel is sharp enough. This is science, right? 80% patience and 20% is cutting things open.
You're weird.
It's time, Mother.
You're weird, mate. Well, everything seems fine enough here, eh? Hey, boys. Okay. Guess we'll go talk to Braddock then. Can't imagine there's too terribly much to explore around here. Just people running all over the place, and I'm sure we'll see most of it before we get back out and going. Oh, you just ran through these things like they weren't there. Is that the secret? This place is filled up with ghosts? I knew it. Whoa, wait, where are we going? Main deck, okay. Okay, damn big buckaroo.
Hey, boss. Nice to see everything still running as smooth as ever.
I knew you were still alive.
So where the hell you been?
So, you fought a G-class Acrid, fell down the side of a mountain, landed on the other side of Shaxx Peak, and somehow survived for 2 weeks before you got back into comm range?
Thankfully, the rig was flush with rations and ammo. Lucky timing, I guess.
I don't know if you've got a good luck charm or you are one.
Funny how often luck feels just like getting my ass kicked.
Jim, you know, I take you at your word, of course, but I'm sensing there's a little more to your story.
Well, now that you mention it, where is this?
What is... Where did you find that?
Sensing that you already know the answer to that.
Don't toy with me, Peyton. What did you find?
Why don't you tell me what I found? We're the first humans to set foot on this planet, so obviously I didn't find some 50-year-old Nevek base, did I?
Keep your voice down.
Is that really all you have to say?
No. It's important you understand something, Jim. Keeping the first colony under wraps wasn't my idea. It's one of the terms I had to agree to for Nevek to greenlight this mission in the first place. Perception is vital to their interests. I'll go to great lengths to conceal such a debacle. Kurnas was set to land far, far from the original site, but the storm forced us down here. Nearer to the truth than I could have even ever hoped.
Hoped? Why would you hope for this?
That's why. General Charles Braddock, commander of the first Neo-Venus Colonial Expeditionary Force.
Man led the first colony.
Led it, and lost it. And he was never the same. Something happened here. Something you would never talk about.
Right. So, you're here to what? Fulfill your father's dreams? Redeem his failures?
Repeat his history?
To solve the energy crisis. And maybe get some answers with your help. Consider this an opportunity. Standing contract for further investigation. Not for Kurnas, but for me personally. And I'll pay a premium for your ongoing discretion.
So I get to lie to everybody, too?
If a word of this reaches Nevek, they'll take back the whole operation. Put it under paramilitary command. I hate lying to the men, Jim, but it's for their own good. Trust me.
Why can't we just forget the whole thing? And, I mean, you know. You forget about it too, Braddock, and we'll just all be happy. And, just pretend that it never existed. It's gone.
By the way, Jim, a supply drop came in while you were away, and if I'm not mistaken, we got all the parts we need for a couple of major upgrades to your rig.
Oh, yeah.
A gas torch. I've got some contracts for you on the new pipeline, so, I need you ready to do some welding. The other upgrade? Well, I'll just let Gail show you that one.
We's got upgrades? Oh, we's got upgrades to our thingy. Okay. So we gotta go down to Chinatown. Down the elevator. Don't ask me what I'm singing. I'm just a bit bored. Yes, but we're back to story. Not much action. Just lay low for a little while. This game is fairly well paced, but at the same time, they could mix story in with the action a bit more. Then just, oh, go here. Oh, okay, you fought some Acrid. Now it's time for long bits of story.
What'll it be?
What don't I have? Eh. Okay, what do we have down here? Shotgun.
That ought to tone down your recoil quite a bit.
That's
good. Smart purchase, no question.
Disc grenades. Okay. Hunting rifle, 8x scope. Don't really need that. And yeah, I would say we're actually probably pretty good. Yeah, we don't really need bounce shot. It's not like we're going to try to bounce things off walls. Let's go see Gale. Oh, Gale! Oh, Gale! My fine sir, what do you have for me?
Man alive! Jim, I'm glad you're back. It was a long couple of weeks. Of course I told him you'd make it. Never a doubt in my mind.
Oh, won't Braddock be happy? His favorite, back from the dead.
LaRoche is happy to see you too. Hey, major upgrade time for you. Parts came in for an acetylene torch. Sexy, right? I can slap that together in no time. But the other upgrade, it's gonna take significant surgery, but you're gonna love it.
No!
Consider it a little welcome home gift from Braddock and yours truly.
By the way, Jim, where are you looking?
Swing arm. Platform compatible. All the access holes line up and everything if we want to fully convert. You game?
I trust you, Gale. And if you hurt her, I'll cut your arms off.
Sweet!
Guess that means you aren't going to hurt her, eh? Wait, so we're completely upgrading the chassis? Be great if we could actually see something here.
This is it, Jim. My masterpiece. Your rig can now transform into a drilling platform. The suspension might feel a little tighter, and sorry about that, but you're gonna lose your mind when you see what your rig can do now. LaRoche, no begging for one. Giving you enough chances.
Fancy but useless, huh? What good is a drilling platform without knowing the location of deep thermal pockets?
Shush! You're ruining the high. Jim, you were also officially upgraded with a Mitchell Industries oxyacetylene torch. Dual 150 oxygen regulators with a custom thermodyne cutting tip. It's a small flame for welding
cut
everything,
out.
So don't expect to melt the environment.
Oh, it's not cut out for you guys, luckily, so you'll hear all this.
Gotta say, proud of this one. Just check the valve reseals on the cylinder from time to time.
And the Frankenstein rig keeps growing.
Yeah.
LaRoche, can I have a second alone with Gale?
Duh. I don't want to be here for this anyway. Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Listen, Gale, can you look at getting a replacement for this purifier?
Dude, this is like 50 years old. I don't think a modern-day replacement would work with wherever this came from. But I can look at repairing it for you.
Well, that would work. Same difference, right? Or you could adapt a new one to work with the old one. No? No? Okay. Oh, there it goes. So now we have a gas torch and we can... What? Excuse me?
Sweet.
Oh yeah, we might have some stuff that we can do here. So we can access previously inaccessible areas. We can get a hardened hull. That might be good. How many do I have? Only two, I think. No, I have five.
Till next time, boss. Sweet! Let's do this thing.
Let's just go ahead and get an extended winch anyways.
More reach for your winch.
And then I'll need one more piece before we can get the thicker hull, which will just help when fighting aliens, but I think we'll be fine. What's the faster way? I forget. Faster way to the lift. Oh, lifty, lifty, lift. How we love you, lift. How we love the lift. It's a lifty lift. lifts us up high, it takes us down low. It lifts us everywhere that we want to go. I'm just in a singing mood today.
Now that your rig's upgraded, test it out on a deep core T-energy reservoir in the North Plains. Braddock out.
What the? Sorry about those subtitles, so I hope you could hear that. Anyways, we can now go check out something. We could probably go around and... Well, no, she said she'd contact us, so... Yeah, I guess we'll go. So what does it mean it can become a drilling platform? Like what, the drill just goes straight down into the ground or something? I guess we could look at where we could fast travel to. I forgot this was a thing. Whoops. Probably not where we wanted to go.
Tell the problem.
Damn it, Kill!
Oh, sorry, dude. Did you not know I was here?
Do you not remember the conversation we had about personal boundaries?
No, I really don't.
Of course you don't.
Found a problem? Wait, what? Yeah, I think... Can I fast travel again? I can. No, I can't. Well, maybe. Where am I? Just give me the world map here. Okay, so we could have gone straight to the thing. Instead, we're here, I think, which is still fine. We could head over here in a bit. It looks like there's an optional quest over there. Oh, lovely. What am I trying to do here? Ow. Thank you. Oh, you gonna go for your charge attack again? Come on. Is that getting him at all? I have no clue. Hello. Oh, that worked better. Oh, I missed on that one. Come on. Again! And that didn't work. Okay, yes, thank you. Do that one. This might take a while. Oh, how do you like that? How do you like that? What now? That's what I thought. Oh yeah, that feels real good, don't it? Hey now. Don't be so hush. Oh, did you see those skills? Ow. What are you gonna do, huh? Huh, punk? Here, let me just take your arm and get right up on in there. Mmm! Good juiciness right there. Ooh! Ooh! Oh! Aw, dude! Alright, let's see what we can do here, if anything. Wait, yep, we can definitely do something. Ooh. Oh. Ouch. Come on, sprint at me. I missed. There, I got him. Oh, does that feel good? I think so. I think you like it. Oh, you want some more? Yeah, come and get it. We could have avoided this entire battle just by going to the right fast travel. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's good, man. Thank you for all of that. The good juices. Alright, let's move. Oh, is that a little... That's a little shooter. Ooh, so painful. That actually does hurt the rig quite a lot. Stop doing that! Or, you know, we could just go where we wanted to go in the first place. Okay, I think I'm finally learning this fast travel.
I'm so sorry I worried you. I'm fine. I just found myself off the grid for a spell. Nothing I planned on. It's a long story, and you'll hear it, I promise. Just stay strong, doll. Talk soon.
Is this where we're going? Hold on. No, that's not the button. Wait a minute. Oh. Oh. Maybe this is where we're going. Beginning to remember how to fight. Which it's good that they started us out easy again. Alright. Oh, are you serious right now, guys? I think we got what we needed to do here done. Let's get into the rig and see where in the world we are actually supposed to go. Alright, so we were supposed to go further. I just happened to decide to go up there, and we planted an energy T-post, which apparently is something we could just go and do. I don't know anymore. Okay. So, what exactly happens when we make this into a drilling platform? Do we get attacked by everything?
This is looking like a fine place for a deep core reservoir.
No, we actually can't get out right now, so... Oh, this is a lovely view.
Gale Holden, what have you done? Crazy, crazy person.
I can't even see what's going on.
Okay. That's bananas. Gale, do you copy?
Jim? Let me guess. You just put Gertie into platform mode, didn't you? Is that not insane?
Yeah, that's insane.
Time, no doubt about it.
Here's how it works.
Where did all this come from?
You'll have a limited amount of time before thermal pressure collapses the pocket. So keep the rig functioning at all times to get every last drop of T-energy. The rig won't self-repair while platformed, so you'll have to make repairs by hand.
Wait, why will I need to make repairs?
About that. See, the deep core drilling causes intense vibrations, so you'll likely attract...
acrid.
Every acrid in the area.
Probably good.
Should've mentioned that earlier. Whoops, have fun, gotta go.
Yeah, you should've mentioned that earlier. Where? Where are you? Blighters. Get out of the way. How do I manually make repairs, though, if, let's say, rig gets damaged too much? I am hearing a lot of them right now. It doesn't look like there's an area to make repairs, though, so... I mean... although it is getting hurt, so... there's that as well. Uh-oh. That means something new is coming. There we go. Okay, so I just... Where am I going to hold... press and hold V to repair. Where is this? Alright, here it is. There we go. That's what you call repairs. So this is kind of like a wave game. Okay, let's get out of here. My word. Yep. It's kind of like... one of those games where you have to protect something, and, you know... now, you know, that's just not really fair up there. Oh. Bugger it all! Someone's still up there attacking. I mean, it sounds like it. Hold on, guys. I'm gonna work on repairs here. As long as I can repair faster than they can destroy, we're good. Of course, that being said, that isn't the easiest thing in the world to do when you're being attacked. Okay, how in the crap are you expected to do this? Well, that sounds pleasant right there. I'm not holding V. Game. Yeah, I really don't care. And the acrid are running. Always a good sign. Who's up next? Well, hopefully no one. Oh boy, I'm concerned now. Anyways, we survived that wave, apparently. Oh. Scheiße. Hey, don't do that! You fool. I mean, he's almost dead. Shotgun is your best friend on these guys. Should we just see if we can repair fast enough? You know, after this guy. Come on, repair it a little bit at least. Oh, sounds like that wave is probably done. Okay, on to the next one. What in the... Oh, good. It's you! One thing's for sure, this one isn't gonna be so much about protecting my rig as, protecting myself. Yeah, just reload, Peyton, you know, it's fine. Oh, ow, thank you. Ow. Thank you again. You feel good about that? And that's the way I killed you last time, by shooting you in the mouth, so... Yeah, just keep holding your mouth open. That'll work. Wait, it's done. Can we get in and just take this guy out? Can we just get in, or do we have to finish? We have to finish, of course. Seem a bit confused there. Yeah, I don't think I'm supposed to be hiding under here when fighting this guy, but you know. Okay, yeah, it can still get damaged. Well, I'll leave it alone then. We don't want to damage that too much. Come here, you biggin. I'll start taking the ice off the outside of your shell here. Reload, Peyton, you need to... Oh, do we have no more bullets, do we? That is ominous. Oh, of course, it's a burst rifle. Alright, yeah, this is working. There we go. Oh, that's...
You got it, Peyton.
Definitely fun, isn't it? Can I, like, break this? Yeah, kind of. Enough to get the stuff. Guess I didn't realize that before. Okay, so you can shoot up their corpses. That's how you get the extra T energy. Wish I would have known that earlier when fighting bosses for the first time. Love how those are just normal enemies now. It's like, yeah, it's normal enemies. See them every day. And here we go, re-transforming into
Jonas, Peyton, deep drilling's complete.
That's crazy.
Excellent work, Jim.
Hey, look.
Jim, it's Roman. It's time we met on that topic we discussed earlier.
Oh, sure.
In fact, it's urgent. Come see me at my pod as soon as you're able.
Oh, well, I mean, you know, I'd prefer to come up here first. Because, I mean, you know, it's like a little secret. Nothing else up here. But, yeah, now we can get that one thing that I wanted. So, I'll be heading back. Actually, first we might go somewhere and do a secondary quest. Look at that! My money count is still going up! Oh, okay, it's done. We got so much money from that. My question is there anything else to do with this thing? What else can we do with you? I guess nothing. It just does things. Hopefully I didn't turn myself around there. Wait, so I can't fast travel now? Is that what you're telling me? Is that what you're dingle-dong telling me? Can't I fast travel? I guess not. Wait, what? So we were supposed to just go ahead and go there, eh? We'll cut this out. Actually, that being said, this has definitely been long enough for an episode, so thank you all so much for watching Lost Planet 3. And join me next time when we go to see Dr. Roman at her pod. I realize this might have been a little bit of a longer episode, but I hope you don't mind. So until next time. Oh, look at you. Think you're so high and mighty.